my name is Billy Floyd. That is
the Commodore.
That's right, baby. We're the Kitchen Killaz from Orlando, Florida. Classified as a touring acoustic duo, crushing kitchens around the country. We do it every Friday. We do it. And tonight we have some maniacs in the kitchen tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Call them maniacs.
Oh yeah, I would. And thank you guys so much for the love and support. Now do me and the Commodore a solid and prepare your minds, bellies, and souls, ladies and gentlemen, for the show is about to begin. Looks good. Look at this overlay. Look at this overlay. That looks fantastic. What's up, everybody? Hello, hello, and welcome to Friday night. My name is Billy Floyd. I am a kitchen killer. That's right, man. I'm here with the great and illustrious Jess B. We also have a pre-recorded Stephanie, which I'm really excited about. Stephanie Sutton created some fantastic. There she is. What's up, Stephanie Sutton? So this is our banner of the evening. I just wanted to give a little homage to these beautiful ladies that are going to be hosting this evening. So the pre-recorded videos you're going to see is of a cooking escapade that we had in Mineral Bluff just a few weeks ago. The great Stephanie Sutton, you can see her in this picture right there with hand held to forehead looking into the future. Really excited. And tonight, cooking in real time is the great and illustrious Jess B. She's going to be cooking it up in the kitchen, making it happen, kids. So let's bring this down and introduce you to everybody of the evening. It's great to see you. Thank you guys so much for spending some time with us tonight. We got some fantastic people in the house already. What's up, Amber Crowley? Amber, congratulations on a fantastic performance today. Looked incredible, and I'm excited for our conference call on Monday. I'm going to learn so much, and I hope I can give you a little guidance in some electronic things, Patreon stuff. Hold on, stand by. Let's make sure everybody can hear you. Go ahead and give it up, Jess. What you got?
Hi.
So it's so good to see everybody. How are you there, Jess B? Are you ready to rock and roll?
Oh, I'm fantastic. Yeah. I'm really excited that you chose that photo of
get
me
closer
and Stephanie.
To that mic. Closer.
Because whenever I think of us, I think of us at sea.
Yeah. Yeah, I got you. This photo right here?
Oh, God, yeah. Looking to our future.
Yeah, looking to the future.
She's like, What's she gonna do? What's she gonna cook?
What's she gonna do? What's she gonna cook?
And I'm there as I am, doing nothing.
Yeah, that is true. Just being.
Everybody knows I'm a personality hire.
Just being Jess B.
Oh, yeah.
Just be Jess B.
Constantly.
Just be Jess B. I like it. So the videos you're going to see tonight of Stephanie and I in the kitchen were recorded in Mineral Bluff just a couple weeks ago. Really excited about this. We made Zuppa Di Pesce, which is fantastic. So not only are we going to be introducing you guys to some videos that we shot a couple weeks ago with Stephanie making Zuppa Di Pesce, but we have the great and illustrious Jess B in the house. She's also going to be making Zuppa Di Pesce, following almost exactly the same recipe that Stephanie followed. However, the water's a little different because Mineral Bluff and Orlando, they have two different types of water, but that's pretty much the only differences that we're going to get into. So we got a couple songs for you guys tonight. Some beautiful footage of myself and the great Stephanie Sutton over in Mineral Bluff. And we have Jess B on the mic and in the kitchen this evening creating an incredible menu that we were introduced to. I've had Zuppa Di Pesce before, but I had never seen it made.
Oh,
so
yeah.
It was so cool a couple weeks ago to have Stephanie walk us through all of the individual steps that it took to make it. I've eaten it many times coming from an Italian family, but it was the first time I actually ever saw it being made. And how kind of simplistic, but how rich and savory and cultural and authentic the recipe and the meal itself was.
I've had her mom's Zuppa Di Pesce before.
Ooh,
but I've never
had your mom's Zuppa Di Pesce
before. So,
really?
Hey. I hope everyone, as always, loves hair in their food.
Stop it.
That'll
stop
be a little
it.
Bit of a special.
Get out of here. Listen, you
recipe.
Put that mind in there, that image in their mind, and then people are going to leave because they don't want hair in their food.
How do you know?
Hey, man, I'm just saying.
Maybe they want it.
I have hair too. Maybe they want it. People are weird. So, really good to see everybody. What's up, Iron Man Mo?
That's Stephanie's mom. This is her recipe.
That's
Mo-mo.
Stephanie's mom? What's up? I saw that Iron Man Mo liked Kitchen Killaz the other day. I'm like, Iron Man Mo, I don't know who that is, but I love it.
That's Michelle. That's
I love
Mo-mo.
It. What's up, Michelle? Great to see you. Thank you so much for spending some time with us, everybody. We really, really appreciate it. We have some fantastic people in the house tonight. My good friend Mike Conway is here, trimmed and fit, ladies and gentlemen, and single. Just throwing it out there, just to see how it feels, just the tip. And we also have my good man Chris Chapman is in the house tonight with Tally Lockhart also here as well. My good man Johnny, who I just met today, fantastic musician, incredible gamer, and an Apex fan. Also here as well. We have Michelle Hess taking some photos, being the great Michelle Hess. She does her thing. We don't know what she does. We just know it's magical. That's all we really know. We just know it's magic. Full of, it's magical Michelle. She was Michelle Machete.
She's Machete. Pinky's here too. Jessica Pinky, the founder and owner of Dumpster Cat Lashes.
Dumpster Cat Lashes. Well, that's beautiful. Well, before we get into it, kids, I'm going to play a jam for you guys, and then we're going to play the first video of the pre-recorded cooking extravaganza we had at Mineral Bluff just a couple weeks ago. And then we're going to touch base with Jess B. She's already gotten the kitchen smelling amazing. She's got those green peppers, those onions, and those garlics cooking away. So thank you guys so much for spending some time with us tonight. Most certainly appreciate it. As you can see, the bottom camera is our counter cam. Those are all the ingredients that we're going to be, maybe not all, but most of the ingredients that we're going to be using tonight. And Zuppa Di Pesce, if you enjoy the show, please like it and share it on your social media. It's free, which is my favorite four-letter F word, and it really, really helps us bring people in and introduce them not only to the food, but to the music and to the community itself. Again, my name is Billy Floyd. I'm a Kitchen Killer this evening, along with Jess B and Stephanie Sutton. We hope you guys have a fantastic Friday night. Let me grab my Git Fiddle plugger in and do a little rock and roll for you guys. I hope you guys are having a good one, staying out of trouble, living long and prospering, you know, all that good stuff. Yeah, yeah. Don't forget the love ingredient. Oh, Jess B, can you speak of the love ingredient if you have a moment? What is the love ingredient? What is that?
Nothing. Everything's fine.
Everything
is totally cool, totally normal. There's absolutely no reason I put my hair back.
No reason at all. It's totally fine. Everything's great. Everything's normal. We understand 100%. So most certainly appreciate it. Let me hit a button real quick. Oh, yeah, baby doll. So we're going to do a little bit of drift slide collide for you. Let me do this. Boop, boop. Love it. Love it. Got that. Sweet baby Ray. Here we go. Dig it, guys. Thank you so much for spending some time with us tonight. Let me go ahead and solo this bad boy out. Oh, yeah. Does that sound good out there in the house to everybody? You guys hear that? I got a lot of stuff going on. Lainey Lerner, good to see you. And I hope you guys are digging it. As shadows run in circles, silhouetting as they pass me by. On the wall there's prancing ponies, only drifting through this 2D life. Won't you take my hand and trust me? Won't you leap from pain and touch my floor? There's some space right beside me. Just what you're looking for is we drift, slide, collide, explode to something undiscovered and something that could lead my world to love. Slide, collide to something special, special. I might join you in your painting if you join me in my 3D world. I'll run up and horizontal if you would be my 3D girl. As we drift, slide, collide, explode to something unpredictable and something that could lead my world to love. Slide, collide, from mountains with rivers running rapid like waterfalls, I'm coming home to you. Slide, collide, explode to something unpredictable, something that could lead my world to love. Slide, collide, to something special. Collide to something special. Slide, collide to something special. Whoa, 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 no. Whoa, whoa, no. Ah, whoa, oh, yeah. Whoa. as we drift, slide, collide, explode to something undiscovered, something that can lead my world to love. Slide, collide, grow mountains with rivers running rapid, like waterfalls I'm coming home to you. Slide, collide, explode to something unpredictable and something that could lead my world to love. Slide, collide, grow mountains with rivers running rapid, like waterfalls I'm coming home to you. Slide, collide, explode to something unpredictable and something that could lead my world to love. Slide, collide to something special. Collide to something special. Whoa, whoa, oh no. Whoa, as we drift, slide, collide to something special. Yeah, sweet baby Ray. Thank you guys, thank you guys. Let me bring all these bad boys in. What's up, everybody? Great to see you guys, and thank you so much for spending some time with me. I most certainly appreciate it. It was a little Drift, Slide, Collide. You can find it on our first album. But I hope you guys are digging it and have such a fantastic night. I most certainly, I'm looking forward to it. It smells incredible in here, ladies and gentlemen. What's up, Dina? Great to see you. G.W. Pommett, you're in the house. Great to see you. Stephanie Sutton, hello, hello. Josh Mullis, Amber Crowley. You guys got to check out Amber Crowley, man. She's fantastic. Click on her link. Go to Amber Crowley Music. Check it all out, man. She streams a couple times a week. She's on TikTok. She's on Facebook. She's on Instagram. You got to check it out. She's so cute, she's so creative, and she's just got the coolest freaking energy. But let's chat with Jess B real quick and see what she's got cooking up in the kitchen, because it looks fantastic and it smells even better.
I made soup
just and
kidding,
and maker's mark
for Tally.
All right, so before we play this first video with Stephanie, what are the ingredients that you have on the counter there? Because I see some shrimp, some scallops. Looks like a couple different types of tomato sauce. I see some mussels, some pasta. Looks like maybe some cod.
Why ask me if you know all the answers?
I'm guessing. I don't know. Let's actually bring it up. We're going to solo that bad boy out right there. Boom, soloed.
Okay, so mussels.
Mussels.
That's and it. We have some shrimps.
Shrimps. Bowl shrimp.
We have a little bit of scallop.
Ooh, the scallop, so good.
And some fresh cod.
Fresh cod. I love that.
And then some fresh pasta, which I obviously handmade and did not purchase from Publix via Butoni.
We're Italian.
I have some Italian parsley.
Ooh, we went to Italy to get that.
It's really important to source local ingredients for me. And I want authenticity, which is why I have the cento crushed tomatoes.
Ooh.
I have the tutto rosso diced tomatoes because the cento chef's cut tomatoes were not available.
Gotcha.
And then I have the Dei Fratelli Italian sauce.
Man, that looks fantastic. Wow, I love it. And those are pretty much the ingredients that we're going to be using tonight to make the Zuppa Di Pesce. Now, we already have the garlic, the onion, and the green pepper in the pot cooking. Is that accurate? Is that
That's
what I
correct.
Smell cooking?
So right now I have garlic, shallot, green bell pepper, and yellow onion that are cooking down in the pot.
Iron Man Mo says, no calamari.
No calamari.
Stephanie says, it's
Michelle.
Expensive, Ma.
I thought about that later on. Like, as soon as I got home, I was like cutting, looking at things, and I thought, oh my God, Michelle has calamari in her Zuppa Di Pesce, and she's going to be watching, and I didn't get calamari, and maybe I should go back to Publix, but I didn't go back to Publix, and here we are now.
It's too late. But it's going to be fantastic. I'm really looking forward to it.
I do have Pinot Grigio, so I'm hoping.
Yeah, Pinot Grigio. You spell calamari and Pinot Grigio with the same letters, so it's no big deal. It works perfectly.
Yay.
So those are the ingredients that we're going to be using tonight. And in this first video, you're going to see an introduction of me and the great Stephanie Sutton speaking in Mineral Bluff, Georgia. Fantastic Blue Ridge, if you will, in a gorgeous cabin.
Blue Ridge, yeah.
Which was so awesome. So this next video that you're going to see was pre-recorded, the great Stephanie Sutton cooking Zuppa Di Pesce. And tonight in the kitchen, we have Just Jess B cooking. And a Zuppa Di Pesce. We got a couple jams for you as well, but I hope you enjoy this video. Again, these were pre-recorded just a couple weeks ago in Mineral Bluff, and here we go.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Friday Night. My name is Billy Floyd, and this is...
Stephanie Sutton.
That was really good. It's like we've done this before.
I don't know.
Deja vu.
Weird.
Welcome to Friday Night. We appreciate you guys being with us. We are here in beautiful Mineral Bluff, Georgia. The Bluff of Minerals.
Yes.
We are here in Mineral Bluff, Georgia at this beautiful cabin. This cabin is of a friend of yours.
Mm-hmm.
Two friends that you've known for quite some time.
Yes, very long time, since I was 4 years old.
And it's Sandy and Steve.
Sherry and Steven.
Dollar. Sherry and Steven. Sherry with an S.
Sherry with an S.
I love it. Hello, Sherry with an S and Steven with an S. Thank you so much, not only for befriending Stephanie, but for allowing us. We have a really cool crew tonight. We have about 6 or 7 good friends, people super close. I'm new to this circle, this motley crew, if you will. And everybody that I met last night was such a blessing. What a beautiful, beautiful location this is. It's very, very gorgeous. And tonight, not only is what we're seeing gorgeous, but what we're smelling and eating is about to be gorgeous as well. We have Zuppa Di Pesce. Zuppa Di Pesce. Pesca? Pesce. Pesci? P-E-S-C-I.
Pesh. Zuppa Di Pesce.
Zuppa Di Pesce. I was way wrong on that one. Zuppa Di Pesce. Well, now I feel even more Italian. I have to talk with my hands. So we have Zuppa Di Pesce, which is a seafood dish.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked a little bit yesterday. I was raised in an Italian household as well. We had the Feast of Seven Fishes, which was awesome. One of my favorite family meals to go to. I haven't been able to experience that in a long time. And this is such a throwback for me. This is super, super cool. The smells that you get in a kitchen with something like this are things that trigger those nostalgic memories right inside your brain and those little happy thoughts. So we're going to get to that. I'm going to introduce you to Stephanie, who's going to introduce you to these incredible ingredients in tonight's dish, Zuppa Di Pesce.
Zuppa Di Pesce.
Zuppa Di Pesce. I like it. So let's get to it. I'm going to grab the camera. I'm going to give it to this little lady. We're going to find out what she's cooking in the kitchen tonight.
All right, y'all. Follow me. We've got some fun stuff over here. So our ingredients for our Zuppa Di Pesce, we've got some, we went into Ingles, a little grocery store in Blue Ridge, Georgia here. So we got some frozen stuff. Of course, we're not by the sea, unfortunately, but hey, in a pinch, frozen is just as good and just as delicious. We got some delicious garlic butter mussels here that we're going to do. Really nice. And then also some bay scallops, some shrimp, and some fresh cut mahi-mahi there as well. A little bit of a mirepoix to get us started. We've got some nice sweet shallots there. Awesome amount of garlic. I think we could even use more, but hey, it's okay. And then some bell peppers, of course, some butter, and then some spices, and our delicious cento tomatoes that we're going to use for our sauce that we're going to make homemade and cook all this delicious seafood, and it's going to be real good.
Oh man, all those ingredients look so good. I love the presentation. We do have a production director helping us this evening, which is absolutely fantastic. While we get to this, we're going to give you guys a little bit of music to listen to. These last songs were shot at the Demeters in 2021. Here's the first song of the evening. I hope you guys have a good night, and we will see you soon.
Oh, nice edit. These were not shot in 2021. However, we most certainly appreciate you guys hanging out with me tonight. And thank you guys for spending some time with us. So Stephanie Sutton is cooking some fantastic Zuppa Di Pesce, making it happen. And we're really excited because we have Jess B, and she is kicking into the kitchen right now. And she's also making the Zuppa Di Pesce, making it happen for you. I'm going to go ahead and task Michael Conway. If Mike, could you check this camera right there and see kind of what's going on? Because we lost that feed. I don't know if it went to sleep. I don't know what's going on, but I'm going to leave it up to you while I play a jam for you guys. So thank you so much for spending some time with us tonight. Most certainly appreciate it. What's up, Michelle Hess, Kyle Nunez in the house. David Naylor, good to see you, my man. And thank you guys so much for spending some time with me. Most certainly appreciate it. This next one is a cover. This is not an OG. This is a cover by Kenny Chesney called Somewhere With You. So I hope you guys dig it, man. I hope you're having a really good night. And thank you so much for spending some time with us tonight. Tonight, we are making the Zuppa Di Pesce. Very, very good. Super, super tasty. Really, really rich. And all those other things that start and end with me doubling up a descriptive character. So here we go. Let's go ahead and make this happen for you guys. Stephanie Sutton says Mercury retrograde strikes again. It happens.
It do be doing that from time to time.
So here we go, guys. I hope you appreciate this, man. I hope you're digging it, having a fantastic Friday night. If you enjoy the show, please like and share it. Find us at Kitchen Killaz on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, all that good stuff. Throw us a like, throw us a follow, and we'll follow you back. Here we go. You're going out with someone new. I'm going out with someone too. I won't feel sorry for me. I'm getting drunk, but But I'd much rather be somewhere with you, like the line of a carnival riding, driving around Saturday night, make fun of me, singing my song. Got a hotel room just to turn you on. Said pick me up at 3 a.m. You're fighting with your mom again. And I'll go somewhere with you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I won't sit outside your house, wait for the lights to go out. Call up an ex to rescue me. Climb in their bed, but I'd much rather sleep somewhere with you, like we did on the beach last summer when the rain came down and we took cover down in your car out by the pier. Lay me down, whispered in my ear, I hate my life, hold on to me. Or if you ever decide to leave, then I'll go. I can't go out every night of the week and go home with anybody I meet. But it's just a temporary high, 'cause when I close my eyes, I'm somewhere with you. Somewhere with you. If you see me out on the town and it looks like I'm burning it down, you won't ask and I won't say, but in my heart I'm always somewhere with you, like the line of a carnival ride, yeah. Driving around Saturday night, make fun of me, singing my song. Got a hotel room just to turn you on. Said pick me up at 3 a.m. You're fighting with your mom again. And I'll go. I can't go out every night of the week and go home with anybody I meet. But it's just a temporary high, 'cause when I close my eyes, I'm somewhere with you. Baby, good to see you guys. Thank you so much for spending some time with me tonight. Yeah. All right, Mike Conway, what happened? What's going on? Walk me through it, my senior engineer.
Everything's operating correctly.
Can I get to come back up? However, we just have not shut it down yet.
Haven't shut it down yet.
That's because I am a novice when it comes to iPhones and of the sort.
Oh, I like it.
I'm an Android guy, so.
I get it. So let's do this. I'm going to give Jess B this solo camera right here, bink, and I'm going to let her talk, and you can bring me that camera. Just unplug it from the power right there and bring that over here, and we'll tickety talk about it, and I'll figure it out.
So right here we have some mussels that were freshly sourced from Publix over here in Maitland. And the best part about this is I really need the videos of Stephanie making the Zuppa Di Pesce, because I wasn't paying attention at all when I was at the cabin. I was just grinning from ear to ear, smiling, watching my best friend and my gentleman friend enjoy a time together, making seafood, laughing. Gross. I know. It was pretty gross.
It was gross.
It was super fun. So we also have Italian parsley. As I said before, we have some shrimp that was fresh that, I don't really like touching the shrimp when you have to like peel it and devein it. I'm a little bit of like a princess in that regard and in many other regards. But for this event, I did, you know, crack open the shrimp and I did my thing. These scallops, cut them in half because, you know, I thought less people were coming.
Yeah, we're up and running, dog.
Oh, hi, I'm back. Hi.
I love it. There's Jess B. having that wine. So would you like to watch video too so we can see what we're supposed to do?
I not only would I like to watch it because it makes me smile watching you guys together.
I need to watch it
because I don't remember what I'm supposed to do next. Because as I mentioned before, I was not paying attention because just a fun fact about me as a person, anytime I don't have to pay attention, I am not paying attention. If you're ever around me and you think, oh, Jess has a weird look on her face, I wonder what she's thinking. Absolutely nothing. Taking a mental break. It's peaceful in here.
It's so nice. Especially
when I'm around people that I trust as much as I trust Billy and Stephanie. I'm like, oh, what a nice little vacation.
I can let my guard down.
Someone's going to tap me on the shoulder if I need to do something important.
Well, let's watch the second video and figure out what we're supposed to do next. Now, I think what she's about to do, you've already done, but we're about to get there. Let's play the second video. Again, this is shot at Mineral Bluff. The lovely and illustrious Stephanie Sutton whipping up some Zuppa Di Pesce just a few weeks ago.
Blues Clues.
Here we go.
But right now, it is already smelling incredible here in the kitchen. Stephanie's back there. She's getting ready to get the base of this Zuppa Di Pesce going. Just a couple simple ingredients. She's got a little butter in the bottom of a pot. She's warming that up a little bit, and she's going to add a couple more vegetables in there. So we're going to go talk with her and see what vegetables she's putting in there. Why is she putting them in there? Now, what kind of seasonings is she going to use? Before I get off and I say something wrong that I don't necessarily know what I'm talking about, let's chat with Stephanie and see what she's got going on.
Hello, welcome back. All right, so we're gonna start here with our shallots. I've got the butter going in the pot right here, so we'll just dump those bad boys in. Ooh. Get a nice sizzle on that. We'll go ahead and stir them around a little bit, and just coat them with the butter, making sure it gets on all sides of the onion. We're just gonna reduce that down, let it sizzle for a little bit, get into all the parts of the onion. And typically when you're making like a tomato sauce like this, this stuff is gonna get so far cooked down that it just becomes like the flavors into the sauce, which is really cool. So it's okay if they, go for a while. You can kind of use your discretion of how much you want. You want actually some chunks of onion in there? Do you want some chunks of bell pepper still? Or do you want to just have the flavors of it? And you can kind of just let it cook down and reduce as long as you want. And with a traditional, Italian kind of sauce, soup kind of situation like we're getting into here, the longer it sits, the more delicious it becomes. So fun things. We're gonna go throw the bell peppers in now because I feel like those onions have had a little bit of time to sizzle. So throw these bad boys in. Everybody in the pot, no stragglers, no one left behind. And then we'll roll those bell peppers in. This is a very deep pot, so I hope you guys can see in this okay. We're gonna make, we're cooking, I know Billy mentioned we're cooking for like 7-8 people. We have a bunch of friends that are here on a climbing trip, so they're having a great time. And we just decided to hang out and cook for them, so aren't we nice?
I like this. So the garlic, the green peppers, the onions, mm-hmm. in that little bit of butter in the bottom of that pot.
Yes.
And then you're going to cook those until they're soft, until they're...
Pretty much till they're soft, and okay. then I'm going to add the tomato sauce in after that. Because we are cooking with seafood, we're going to get that nice and cooked and the flavor where we want it. And then this is going to be the last thing that goes in, because those shrimp, those scallops, that fish, we don't want to overcook it. So we just kind of want to warm it up in the sauce, and it's going to get all those nice, delicious flavors in it.
Oh. We're getting there. We are getting close. So those are the couple ingredients we're going to get started. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with us tonight. A little bit of a different concept in the middle of the different concept, and I know you guys are liking it. This Zuppa Di Pesce smelling amazing. Here's another song. We hope you guys enjoy it, and we will see you in just a moment. Take care.
Oh, yeah, baby. Let's rock and roll. So those are the initial steps that we're walking through, and right now I think Jess pretty much got almost all of them except for one very, very important one. But we've taken care of that now.
Yeah, it's super fun because not only did I forget calamari, I cooked with olive oil, not butter. So I've remedied it. We're great. Everything is fantastic. And I'm really excited about it.
I love it, Mike. You might have to flip that camera. How's that? How's it looking on your end?
Like Mike?
It's nice and black here. I love it. It looks fantastic. Well, while we're doing... Ooh, look at this. I can drag and drop. Hey, hey, hey. Well, let me play another jam for you while the great Mike Conway, our engineer of the evening. If you guys want him to engineer your camera, he will. Go to michaelengineermycamera.com/kitchenkillaz and get a 10% discount on having your camera engineered by the great Michael Conway. Just making it happen, baby, making it happen. So appreciate you guys hanging out with us tonight. Thank you so much for spending some time. Kebobbing around, making some delicious food with just Jess B. And we are here with the Zuppa Di Pesce tonight. So, oh no. Oh, Iron Man Mo is crying. She literally said, ah, no olive oil. I'm crying.
I put butter. I promise.
It doesn't take very long. And Jess B just messed the whole thing up, man. That's how we do. But she's going to save it. She's going to bring it back from the depths of destruction. She's going to make it happen. I believe in her.
I did both. To be honest with you, I over-prepared. I put olive oil and butter. So you have something for everyone.
Iron Man Mo, she just says, no!
Capital N-O, no.
Does she live here in Florida?
She lives in Jensen Beach.
Oh, no. Stuart. She's going to drive here.
Yeah, and I'm a little scared.
I would be scared. Iron Man Mo, there we go.
You know, I love direct feedback. Love a little direct feedback.
We love direct feedback. Well, to give you guys something prettier to look at than me, I'm going to keep all these cameras up, and we're gonna play this jam, and I hope you guys are digging it. And this next one is called Jilted Lover. This is a KK original. I wrote this quite some time ago, and I hope you guys are digging it, man. I hope you're having a fantastic night. Thank you so much for spending some time with me. Let me hit this button and make sure it works. Oh, yep. Let me see. Oh, yeah, I don't hear that through the speakers. Fantastic. So here we go. This is a little Jilted Lover for you guys. If you don't like it, it's Josh Mollis's fault. Down everything around me, skipping steps to save me, keeping fire from mice. And frozen is my will and power to be free, despite the world around me. I'm broken by design, and I believe that I will stand alone. And I will bear my soul in hopes you lay to rest the hatred in your heart. And let me see, the love will find a way to send all my pain away, to shelter shattered dreams that you lost along your way. And I'll stand alone, ignoring your belief in a system built with paper beams, supporting dreams of a vision that you'll never work to see. But I will find my way despite the time it takes. The world was built in 7 days, and in a 7 days I break. So please believe the love will find a way to send all my pain away, to shelter shattered dreams that you lost along your way. And I'll stand alone, bare feet burning on that stone, by singing with my words. My soul will raise the clouds as angels ring out loud, and I'll stand alone. I'll stand alone, oh, with bare feet burning down on that stone. Oh, and by singing with my soul, with my soul. And I believe that I will stand alone, and I will bear my soul in hopes you've laid to rest the hatred in your heart. And let me see, the love will find a way to send all my pain away, to shelter shattered dreams that you lost along your way. And I'll stand alone, bare feet burning on that stone, by singing with my soul. My words will reach the clouds as angels sing out loud. And I'll stand alone, bare feet burning on that stone, by singing with my soul. Thank you guys very much, man. That was awesome. thanks for letting me play for you guys. I appreciate that. That's a lot of fun. Let me hit the buttons. Let me hit the buttons. Let me do one of those, guys. Do one of those. Do one of those. Do one of those. Check, check, check. And let me hit that button right there. Cool, baby. Oh, thank you very much, Iron Man Mo. Iron Man Mo said she's in the car. She's commenting from her phone, and she's on the way here.
Momo.
Ooh, somebody in trouble. So what's up, Jess B? You look like you got some garlic bread over there.
Yes. What, the butter that I forgot to put with the onions and the bell peppers, I did put on some bread.
Okay.
And I made a little garlic bread.
We like that.
I definitely made this homemade. It wasn't something I bought in a package and then just like stuck in the oven. That would be way too easy.
We grew that bread.
I am not that kind of woman.
Yeah. We grew that bread on our bread tree.
I grew that bread on a bread tree that I've had since my grandmother's grandmother planted that bread tree when she came over from Puerto Rico.
Great mama's bread tree.
Just kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Italy.
Yeah. Yeah. Great mama's bread tree.
Puerto Rico.
Yeah. It's fantastic. Three different types of bread.
Yeah. Three different types of bread. That's true.
Tally Lockhart says, bread is amazing. I agree. It is amazing. All right. Sweet, Jess B. So what is the next step there? Do we need to play another video?
I really don't know. I need to play another video.
Okay, we're going
to... I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm sweating. I need to know where the butter goes. I'm dying inside. I know Michelle's watching.
All right.
I'm still invited to Christmas Eve dinner, so that's good. But honestly, like, the next couple steps are really, really important because if I don't get this right... That means neither of us get the Feast of Seven Fishes.
Yeah, somebody's going to be in trouble. I agree. Somebody's going
to
be in trouble.
I want your family to see this too, because I know they're also Italian.
I hear that. Well,
From Salerno.
That's right. Here is video number three of Stephanie Sutton and myself in Mineral Bluff. Stephanie is cooking up some Zuppa Di Pesce, and we have Jess B here trying to mimic the great Stephanie Sutton, whipping up our own Zuppa Di Pesce right here in the KK kitchen with a C.
I've been trying to mimic her since ninth grade, so here we go again.
Oh, it's always good to look up to our heroes. You know, would they say imitation is the fondest form of flattery?
Correct. You are correct.
You are correct. Here's a video.
Speaking of that, it is smelling amazing. We love spreading the love. We're going to spread a little seasoning here coming up next. We're going to chat with Stephanie. She is going to be telling us exactly what seasoning she's using. She's going to walk you a little bit through the chemistry of why she's adding what she's adding and why she's adding them in the order that she's adding them. So... without me going any further here, let's take a bit of a pause and speak with this lovely lady and see what she's got cooking in the kitchen.
Welcome back, y'all. So we're getting ready to add a couple seasonings, but I gotta correct myself real quick. So I said we're here on a climbing trip. We're here on a golfing trip, not climbing. And everybody here, that they're all like friends that used to be climbers. And so there's where we used to climb and do all that fun stuff. And now we just golf and go on golf trips in cabins. So. That being said, sorry friends, let me correct myself. Anyways, we're gonna add a little sea salt, ooh, fun times here, into our mirepoix mix. So with this, a little bit of the sea salt, adding it in when we're trying to reduce these down is really gonna help draw a lot of the moisture out of the bell peppers, out of the onions, out of the garlic. And then once we kind of get that mixed up and stirred around, we're gonna add the tomato sauce. And start going with that. So that's gonna really, the moisture is gonna draw out, but then we're gonna rehydrate these bad boys in that tomato sauce. So all that water is pulled out and the tomato sauce gets injected right in. It's good stuff. Talking about those layers and layers of flavors, that's how we can kind of help achieve some of those delicious things that, you know, these delicious Italian traditional sauces are known for.
And again, a lot of simple ones. Black pepper, sea salt, basil, garlic powder, Italian seasoning.
Yeah.
Just some real simple stuff. But again, those simple ingredients in the right order, in the right way, with the right amount, mm-hmm. can really create some magical stuff, man.
That's good stuff.
Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. I hope you're enjoying this. So for those of you that are just checking in, this was previously recorded here in the mountains of Georgia. The signal isn't incredibly powerful, so we did previously record what you're seeing now. Thank you guys for the comments. I'm in the comments right now talking to you in real time as I'm not in real time talking to you on the camera in the comments. How crazy is that?
That's all true. That is all 100% accurate. I am here in the comments talking to you guys in the comments while we talk in the comments and you guys see the comments while we're actually experiencing some real comments in real time after the pre-recorded comments that we are making happen. So let's see. We got standby. Boop. Got it. Muted. No. N-O spells. No, I don't know. I don't know. Technology is fighting with us tonight. We don't know what's going on, but it's going to be fun. A beautiful cabin. Absolutely fantastic. You're absolutely right, Stephanie. It was such a beautiful time. We had a really, really, really lovely time in that cabin. Just a couple of days that we were there. Very serene, very peaceful. We actually had Sherry on the show on Wednesday. She's the owner and the operator of that gorgeous cabin. And you can find it online. You can rent it. It's a beautiful Airbnb. It doesn't take very long. It's very, very affordable. It's got a four different bedrooms. So if you get a good crew of people together, it's extremely inexpensive for you guys to be able to enjoy an absolutely beautiful time in Mineral Bluff for a couple of days. Just relax, enjoy nature. It's gorgeous. The views are beautiful. It was such an amazing time. I'm always excited to get back home, but I was a little bit sad to leave. Most certainly, I was a little bit sad to leave, but it was a beautiful cabin. And a huge shout out to Jess B, to Stephanie, for everybody for inviting me along. And you can head to lovemycabin.com. There it is right there. It is an absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous location. And again, extremely affordable, really, really beautiful. It's far enough away from everything, so you have a little bit of isolation, but it's also close enough to everything to where if you need anything, you can get it in a pretty short period of time. So we are hanging with Stephanie Sutton tonight. She is cooking with pre-recorded footage, a Zuppa Di Pesce. And we also have Jess B in the kitchen. She's making it happen as well. We have Zuppa Di Pesce. And we're going to go ahead and play another one of these videos, see if we can keep up to these ingredients and find out exactly what's going on. We have no idea what's next. We have no idea what's up, but I know it says video four, and this is for you.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back. While the items are cooking down, like Stephanie said they needed to, because listen, we're legit. We got to keep ourselves occupied. We have to keep our minds sharp. So again, we are here in beautiful Mineral Bluff, Georgia at this gorgeous cabin. And right outside of this three-level beautiful home is this gorgeous patio, which is just, it's just beautiful. 10 out of 10. And right behind us, you see the champion. That's right. She's the 2021 champion of the string on a ring, the ring on a string, the hook game with all the things going on. And it takes a lot of love. It takes a lot of finesse. And this is what we spend our time doing as true professionals. This is just really it. We just focus on this hook, and we focus on getting that ring on the string on the hook. Oh, getting so close.
The struggle is
so
real.
This is where we are. An absolutely gorgeous location.
Great views. There it goes. With Italian cooking, we gotta find some way to occupy ourselves sometimes while these things cook down. If you want the flavors to be good, it takes a while. So we're out here, we're flexing our skills, physical, mental, all of it, playing with things in a beautiful
and
setting.
And again, what a beautiful setting.
My mountain dream, that's the name of the cabin.
This is gorgeous. So
good stuff.
With stuff like this, this is a private residence that is rented out. Can other people come here too? Like,
yeah,
how does that all work out? They have a website and they're like, you know, a professional company and such?
Yes. So Sherry is one of my best friend's moms, so she's kind of like my mom. I've been best friends with her daughter Ashley since we were 4 years old. We went to preschool together, so I've kind of grown up with Sherry, you know, kind of as a second mom. So it's really fun to come to her cabin and hang out. But they have a website, lovemycabin.com, where you can go and book directly through there. And they're also listed on Airbnb, so you've got a couple different options. And I've been to a couple cabins. I live in Chattanooga, Tennessee, which is about an hour and a half away from here, hour and a half west. And this is one of the nicest cabins I've been to. Like, not even just saying it because it's my friend's mom's cabin, like my second mom's cabin, but like, it is nice. They take care of this place. It's clean, the beds are comfortable. It's an awesome place to come hang out.
Yeah, for sure. It is really, really beautiful. And make sure you book those locations. It's year round, I think you can.
Yeah,
you
year
can
round.
Rent this place year round. Mm-hmm. So be sure you guys check that out.
That's for sure. That's absolutely 100% real, man. So thank you guys so much for spending some time with us tonight. Most certainly appreciate it. And I will say this, that website is real. I know I make them up a lot. I really do. But Love My Cabin is a real website. You can go there. You can check it out. You can rent it. You can get a bunch of friends together. It's gorgeous. It's relaxing. It's comfortable. It's got everything you need. As soon as you walk in there, you are fully at home. You are fully taken care of and ready to just relax immediately, which is the way that Sherry and Steve do it. It was such a blessing having Sherry on the show the other day. It was really, really lovely working with her and talking with her. She is a mover and a shaker. She is a hard-working woman, and she worked extremely hard to be able to experience the life that she has, and I'm so grateful that she then opened up the doors to that beautiful cabin and shares it with anybody who wants an escape, wants to be able to get up there and really experience nature and the quietness of it. I got to the cabin and I didn't leave until it was time to go. Everybody else is like, I'm going to go play golf. I'm going to go down. Nope, you can find Billy in the cabin or on the patio throwing the ring on a string. That's pretty much what it was. It was really nice to be able to break apart. But Love My Cabin is real. That is a real one. There we go. I love it. Fantastic, Mike Conway. You won. You win. You win.
Now he's good at iPhones.
That's right. Okay, Jess B. So what do we got going on? What's the next step here?
I put the rest of the tomato sauce and the diced tomatoes in. And I'm going to stir it with a big wooden spoon.
I love it.
Season it. Got to do the salt, pepper, oregano, Italian seasoning, dried, of course.
Yeah.
And that's where I'm at right now with it. I put a cup, not a cup. Like I pretty much like took water and rinsed out the tomato can.
Gotcha.
And dumped it in there to make it like more saucy, not more saucy, to like dilute the sauce, I suppose.
I gotcha.
Zuppa is like a soup.
Yeah, it's soupy.
I hope that is correct.
It is correct.
I am sure that I will be,
Iron Man Mo said, always the wooden spoon.
Yes. See, that's why I had to make a point of saying it's a wooden spoon.
Yeah, always the wooden spoon.
Hang on one second, I'll get it.
I think she slowed down a little bit. She was doing like 120 on the highway up here she got angry with you over the olive oil, but I think she dropped it down to a healthy 90 now that she knows you're using the classic wooden spoon. That's right. That's right from Italy.
It's like Ludacris said, I'm doing 100 on the highway. So if you do the speed limit, get the
out of my way. I hear you.
Yeah.
I hear you.
Here's the wooden spoon.
There it is. Look at that wooden spoon.
Isn't that nice?
That's a gorgeous wooden spoon. Okay, Iron Man Mo said no, she's doing 88. She's not doing 90.
Are you on your motorcycle or are you are you in the FJ? Are you in the FJ or are you in the Jag? In the Jag? You're in the motorcycle? You're in the FJ? I need to give me a report back.
Uh-oh.
Where are you coming from? Are you coming from the VFW? Where are we dealing with right now? She's in the Jag.
Bellissima, Bella. Bellissima. So thank you guys very much for hanging out with us tonight. Most certainly appreciate it. I'm going to rock a jam for you guys. Then we're going to check in. She's in the helicopter. Iron Man Mo said she's in the helicopter. That's right. I'm going to jam a jam for you guys. Then we're going to check in with Jess B. We're going to see what she's got cooking in the kitchen. And she's got something else to say. I'm excited.
I was going to say, Michelle used to, she was in the Orange County Sheriff's Department. And she used to fly helicopters. So this is not only, a recipe that comes from somebody I've known my entire life, but she's law enforcement. So if I mess up, she knows people who know people in Orange County. And I'm scared. Not really. Love you.
Oh, wow. You can't mess with those Italian families, man. They make it happen. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with us tonight. Most certainly appreciate it. I'm going to go ahead and rock this like docket, and I hope you guys dig it, man. This is a little... actually, I haven't played this one by myself in a really long time, so we're going to see how it goes, but I hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you are enjoying the show again here with Stephanie Sutton, pre-recorded material from Mineral Bluff, making Zuppa Di Pesce, and we have Jess B. in the kitchen making Zuppa Di Pesce, rocking some jams for you, and thank you everybody who is in the chat right now. Thank you very, very much for your support and for your follows. We love this. We do it every Friday and we do it for free. So let us know if you want us to crash your kitchen. We travel, ladies and gentlemen, and we would be super, super happy to travel to your kitchen to make this happen. So I hope you guys are digging it and having a fantastic night. Give me a second. Let me hit some buttons and we'll rock some tunes for you.
Good, good, good. Good, good, good.
My friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you who you know. Please don't make any sudden moves. You don't know the half of the abuse. All my friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you who you know. Make any sudden moves. You don't know the half of the abuse. Welcome to the room of people who are rooms of people that they love and they docked away. Just because you check the guns at the door doesn't mean your brains will change from hand grenades. You're loving on a psychopath sitting next to you. You're loving on a murderer sitting next to you. You're thinking that I get there sitting next to you. But after all I've said, please don't forget. All my friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you who you know. Please don't make any sudden moves. abuse. We don't deal with outsiders very well. They say newcomers have a certain smell. Yeah, trust issues, not to mention. They say they can smell your intentions. You're loving on a freak show sitting next to you. You'll love somewhere people sitting next to you. You're thinking that I get there sitting next to you. But after all I've said, please don't forget, watch it. All my friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you, you know. Please don't make any sudden moves. You don't know the half of the abuse. All my friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you, you know. All my friends are heathens, take it slow. Wait for them to ask you, you know. Why'd you come? You know you should have stayed. I try to warn you just to stay away. And now they're outside ready to bust. It looks like you might be one of us. One of us.
Sweet baby Ray. Thank you guys, thank you guys. Hope you guys are having a good one. Thank you very much for spending some time with us tonight. Let me hit that button, let me turn that down, let me turn this up, let me, that's what I play to every single song, boop, boop. All right, let's chat with Jess B and see what's going on, because it is smelling good, it is looking good, and I'm really excited about this. What's up, Jess B? How's it going over there?
It's going really well. I have seasoned the tomato sauce with salt, pepper, salt, black pepper, white pepper, oregano, Italian seasoning. I put a little bit of crushed red pepper in there because I like a little bit of bite. I like a little picante, a little spicy, just a little picante. And that's pretty much where I'm at right now. I don't know what goes next. I'm assuming it's the seafood because that's pretty much where I'm at.
I think that's where we are, but there's only one way to find out. Let's watch the next video of Stephanie Sutton whipping it up in Mineral Bluff.
I am sweating.
Zuppa Di Pesce. We have Zuppa Di Pesce being made tonight by Jess B, by the coaching of the previous recorded ghost of Stephanie Sutton, making it happen. We were in Mineral Bluff, making Zuppa Di Pesce just a couple weeks ago, and here we are making it in real time with the guidance and the coaching of the great Stephanie Sutton. So let's check this video out and see let's see what's next. And Michelle.
And Mo.
So we hope you guys also are enjoying the music tonight. And we're here with Stephanie Sutton. She's creating Zuppa Di Pesce this evening. A beautiful Italian dish, a delicious soup. She's walked you through some of the basics. And now we're about to add a couple more ingredients. So we're about to step in here and see what she's got going on and what's the next step in this delicious dish. Let's go.
All right. Welcome back, y'all. I keep saying that. More butter is better. So we're throwing some more butter in real quick. Now we're gonna get ready to add our sauce. So we got a little bit of a crisp kind of browning on our garlic and our onions there, which I like. I think it gives the sauce a little bit more depth of flavor, kind of that like roasted, rustic kind of Italian sizzle that we're looking for. I'm gonna stir that in a little bit. And this is just gonna kind of break up some of that caramelization a little bit with that butter. Just add another depth. We're also using unsalted butter, it should be noted. Just because if you use salted butter, that's just going to give you way, way, way too much. So we're going to go ahead and add our tomatoes now. We're going to start with our crushed tomatoes. So we do have some chef's cut tomatoes, which are going to be more of like a whole tomato, just kind of like a stewed, think of like a stewed tomato, but it's still kind of got its tomato form. And then our crushed tomato is going to be pretty much our sauce. So we'll go ahead and throw that bad boy in there, give a little sizzle. Set the can to the side. We'll grab our other one here. A little sizzle on that. Ooh! Good thing for the pot is nice and deep. It's not splashing all over me. Isn't that great? All right. So we'll give that a little stir. We'll wait on our chef's cut tomatoes there for a second. Stir that around. And it's going to take a little bit because, you know, that's a room temperature can. It's going to take a little bit for that to heat up. So just stir it up. Let it sit for a little bit. We'll get that rolling, and then we'll be back.
Awesome. Man, it smells so good in here. Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. Again, a little shift of the normal concept that you guys are normally seeing on a Friday night. We're here in Mineral Bluff, Georgia. The signal in the house that we have is not incredibly powerful. We wanted to make sure we gave you guys some really good video and some really clean instructions on how to cook this incredible meal. And we wanted to be able to add in that music as well. So we're here in Mineral Bluff, Georgia, this gorgeous cabin with Stephanie Sutton cooking some Zuppa Di Pesce this evening. She's walked you through a couple of the beginning steps. She's just added some of the tomato sauce, two of the three cans. She got that chef's cut that she's saving, baby. And while we do that, we got a couple more things we're working on here in the kitchen. So let us go ahead and play another song for you guys. We hope you guys are enjoying your Friday evening. Thank you very much. And please say something in the comments and in the chats. Not only are we in there live, but we hope you guys are enjoying it live as well. Here's another tune and we'll see you soon.
Oh, here's another tune and we'll see you soon. I like that. I didn't do that on purpose, but that was pretty good. And you can go to Love My Cabin. That's a real website. And you can look at this beautiful cabin that we were able to spend some time with in Mineral Bluff, Georgia, not that long ago, enjoying Zuppa Di Pesce made by Stephanie Sutton. And tonight we have Jess B in the house and she is creating her own Zuppa Di Pesce based on the guidance, aside from a little tiny tweaking here and there.
I don't have the chef's cut.
Just a little tiny tomatoes. Tweaking. Nothing, okay, nothing too crazy.
Teeny tiny tweak.
Nothing too crazy. Yeah, so you can grab the handle behind there and you can kind of rotate it up. We took the magnifying glass off there, so we're going to try to see if we're able to maintain.
Bing,
boom. Bing, ding, dong.
Ding, dong.
That's right. So what's next up there, Jess B?
I would like to hear you play a song.
And I can do that.
I would like to see the next clip because that's where I'm at.
Sweet baby Ray. Well, let's go ahead and I'll jam a jam for you guys. Hope you guys are digging it and having a good night. This next one is a KitchenKillaz original. This is called Powered Up. So if you're enjoying your Friday night, I most certainly hope you are. We go back and forth, originals and covers. We're always talking about new food and new menus, new concepts, authenticity, a lot of different cultures. And tonight, making a Zuppa Di Pesce from the guidance of the great Stephanie Sutton. Jess B in the kitchen whipping it up. We have some fantastic fans in the house tonight that are getting ready to enjoy this glorious meal. Kyle Nunez, we miss you, brother. But I hope you guys are digging it and having a good night. Thank you so much for spending some time with me tonight. This is called Powered Up, and I hope you like it. This won't last forever, this reaching out tonight. Where your heart lays now, it's colder. Working hard to mend that heart from life. You were laid upon the table, cut open, removed that heart, unstable life. Replace it with gears and cables. You're powered up, switched on, shut off, unraveled this. Time is mine to tell you what I please. This life is fire, it drops you to your knees. This pain, yeah, reminds me of a time passed by. You see, this broken heart was meant to be. Now rain sounds so much better when you're with me late at night. Where your hands lay now is warmer, working hard to keep that loop alive. I was laid upon the table, cut open, removed my heart, uncabled. You replace it with gears, I'm stable. I'm powered up, switched on, shut off, unraveled. This time is mine to tell you what I please. This life is fire, it drops you to your knees. This pain reminds me of a time passed by. You see, this broken heart was meant to be. So let your love run free to find the warm embrace you need now. Thank you.
And this time is mine to tell you what I please. This life is fire. It drops you to your knees. This pain reminds me of a time passed by. You see, this broken heart was meant to be. So let that love run free and be the warm embrace I need. Why don't you run to me and be the warm embrace I need now?
Yes. All right. What's up, everybody? Good to see you guys tonight. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Let's bring all this stuff up. Let's do this. Let's hit this button right here. Stand by. We're going to go back to this guy. We're going to do that. We're going to do... Oh, we're going to keep that one up and running, and we're going to do that. All right. What's up, Jess B? How's it going over there?
Swimmingly.
Swimmingly. I like swimmingly. Swimmingly sounds fantastic.
It's fantastic.
Yeah. Are you having a good... Are you swimming?
That I
deep
am.
Sigh.
Yeah. That
sweet.
I am.
So, so what is next? Are we adding some seafood? What's going on? Because that seafood's going to cook quick, and Stephanie Sutton's about to tell us all about that. But how's that red sauce looking? Looking good?
It's looking good. It's tasting good. I feel really, really like
confident.
I feel confident about it.
Yeah.
I do. Yeah.
Nice.
You know, ordinarily I question myself when it comes to seasoning, as I'm like, I feel like I needed to add more salt. Ordinarily, I need to add less salt.
Gotcha.
But I feel like I'm in a good spot with it.
Yeah.
Mostly because it's kind of salty right now, and I know when I add all the seafood, it's going to be perfect.
That is very, very true. Yeah. Nice. So let's see. Okay, we're on video number 6. Are you ready to see what video number 6 has to say?
Oh, I'm absolutely ready.
Oh, yeah. Let's see what Stephanie Sutton has for us now.
Tonight, we are in Mineral Bluff, Georgia, here at a beautiful cabin with Stephanie Sutton, working on Zuppa Di Pesce. We've given you guys a lot of these incredible steps in moving forward to make this a delicious dish. Not only do we have an update from Stephanie, but we have a little tip, a little trick, and we're going to learn a little bit about what's going on here. She's working hard in the kitchen, and it is smelling amazing. So let's step back there and see what she's got going and how it is looking.
Come on over. So we've got a nice little rolling bubble on our sauce here. A little rolling bubble. So not a boil, but a rolling bubble. So kind of like a medium high heat or so. With this, what I'm kind of noticing, because we are at a cabin and we have to go to the grocery store and it's not right around the corner, I forgot to get one of my ingredients, which I like to use to thin out some sauces, which is just some nice stock. They're like a fish stock or a vegetable stock, even a chicken stock would work, whatever flavor you kind of prefer. So because we don't have that, we're going to do a quick fix. What I like to do when I forget to have an ingredient is I'll take the can of sauce. It still has some lovely tomato bits in there. And we're just going to fill it with some water. So we're not just putting straight water. We're actually getting to use all the stuff that's still in the can. Give it a little swirl as you fill, just to kind of help clean some of the sides off. And now you've got some lovely tomato water here. And we're just going to carefully dump that in to our rolling bubble. And that's going to help thin the sauce out. With the Zuppa Di Pesce, you want the fish to really be the star. So you don't want a thick, heavy tomato sauce. You want more of a kind of a thin sauce. So with that, we'll get that rolling. And then now I feel good with that consistency. I'm going to go ahead and add our chef's cut tomatoes here. As you can kind of get a little look and see what those bad boys look like. Kind of like a stewed tomato. And we'll just carefully put that in there. That's just going to give a little bit of texture to the sauce versus just having, you know, just tomato paste. Fun time. So with that, I'm going to add a couple of dry ingredients now as well. So we've got some oregano. I am all about the what looks good on the top. I'm like, so I'll do a little layer. I think that'll be pretty nice there. We'll go ahead and stir that in, add the rest of our ingredients, and kind of get rolling.
Nice. Oh, man. That smells so good. Hey guys, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We most certainly appreciate it. It is looking good, it is smelling good, and we are making it right through these delicious steps to make this Zuppa Di Pesce. She walked you through a little bit of a trick. Again, an ingredient forgot. The store is a little far away, so we decided to use what was left in that can to thin that sauce up a little bit. As she said, she wants the seafood to be the star.
She does want the seafood to be the star. What's up, everybody? Good to see you guys tonight. Thank you very much for hanging out with us. And we most certainly appreciate all the things. Man, that camera just does not want to be our friend tonight.
Doesn't matter which direction we're looking
at. He's like, nope. Let's see if we can pop back in there for a second so we can see what she's doing. I imagine we got about 20 seconds. So what's going on, Jess B? How's it looking over there? What step are we up to next?
Well, I'm caught up with the video.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm pleasantly surprised that I did everything instinctually correct.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, applause to me for remembering something, for remembering a situation that I was in.
Okay,
come
we're
on
up.
Over here.
Oh,
come
let's
on
do
on
it.
For
let's
20
do
seconds.
It. Hurry come up on. Before we lose it. There's Johnny, everybody. Yeah,
ready?
Johnny on
watch
the spot.
Out, Johnny.
Yeah, yeah. You got a camera right behind you, dog.
Get in here. Come over here.
Get up close. Get up close.
That bad boy.
Okay.
Stephanie said that it needs to be more of a, I don't want to say watery consistency, but less of a like full tomato-y consistency and more like a soup, Zuppa.
Yeah, she wants the seafood to be the star. So she wanted to thin
she
up that, she wanted
to
thin
to
up that
star.
Tomato sauce. I dig it. That looks fantastic. So what's the next step? Do we add the seafood?
I honestly don't know. And I hope that someone can tell me because I think yes, correct, yes.
Yeah? Okay.
Oh,
well,
yeah, let's play the next one. What say you? Michelle, what say you?
Is this video 7? I think we're on video 7.
Lucky number 7.
Let's go and see what we're doing because we don't know.
We have an educated guess.
We kind of know.
I don't want to say I know because if I knew, it'd be something like, it wouldn't be that fun.
Yeah, yeah. Plus, we're following Stephanie's direct and personal instructions.
Steph Steps.
That's right. Just Jess and Steph Steps.
Just
here we go.
And Steph Steps.
The next video of
we're
Stephanie
adults.
Sutton. That's right. In Mineral Bluff, cooking a Zuppa Di Pesce for you guys this evening. Here we go.
Welcome back, everybody. It is Friday night. I hope you guys enjoyed that last song. I'm here with Stephanie Sutton, and we are closing in on the finishing touches on this Zuppa Di Pesce. We got a couple more things to go, and my favorite part right now is we're about to add a little more of the seasoning and some of this incredible seafood, which is going to be in. Freaking incredible. I'm so looking forward to it. It smells good. It looks good. You can already kind of taste it and smell it at the same time that you taste it and smell it. You know what
I
I'm talking about?
I taste it, though.
I think... Oh, really?
Just a little,
I'm down.
Just, here. What do you think? Ready for the seafood? Nice
oh, my
marinated?
God. Dude, that is so good.
Awesome.
That is so fantastic. Wow. And that didn't take very long at all.
No, not really.
I mean, we're just here. Nice and simple stuff. She's adding some capers now. Who doesn't love capers? Oh, yeah. Rocking them.
Guys right here. Actually, a little berry. So we're going to put these bad guys in. They're going to give a little natural saltiness because they all are pickled. So I'm kind of trying to avoid as much brine there. I don't want to just dump it right in. So kind of scrape them on in that bad boy.
Get them capers up in that bad boy.
Get them in there.
Oh, yeah.
A little fun, little nuggets of joy. And then we're going to add our delicious seafood
here.
Oh,
I'll be your Vanna White.
Yes.
So let's talk about what do we have here? We have some scallops.
Some bay scallops, some shrimps. Peeled, deveined, and detailed because we don't want to mess with that. We want to get to the good stuff.
Don't play
while
with
we're
us.
Eating.
Don't play with us. Mm-mm.
And some fresh mahi that I actually got from their fish case there. Ooh. So there is some fresh mixed in with the frozen there.
If you want Stephanie to devein your shrimp, she'll do it. You can go to deveinmyshrimp.com/Stephanie Sutton. You can sign up. She also has an OnlyFans. We'll get there soon.
It's a little However, painful.
That is a Wow. That looks and smells fantastic. Let's go ahead and join her for this momentous occasion.
So we're going to poop into the pot it goes.
Oh my God, that is going to be so good.
Everybody in. We'll give it a little stir. And so because the pot is at our nice rolling boil, you can already see the shrimp starting to cook.
Oh yeah.
Those bay scallops.
Cooks quick.
So they'll turn nice and pink. The scallops will be nice and firm when they're ready, almost like flaky. So you don't even have to... that's when you know they're done. And seafood cooks really quick. So the reason we don't put that in and keep it cooking is it's just going to cook down and turn into mush, just like the bell peppers and the onions and the garlic and all that stuff. So we want to still hold the consistency of our seafood. It's good that way.
We like textures. We love textures.
Oh, and the mussels. Those bad boys got to go in. These I'm actually going to wait just a second, like right before plating, because they're already cooked. As you can see, they're open. That's how you know the mussels are cooked. So
nice.
We're going to wait on those.
Awesome.
We just need to heat them up.
So we got some pasta to add as well. We're going to wait so that water gets to a nice, beautiful boil. Nice rolling. Is it a bubble or a boil for the pasta, Stephanie?
Definitely a boil, and then we turn it down to a bubble.
Yeah.
So we don't
go to boil, down to bubble. Add your pasta. It doesn't take very long, especially the pasta that we have. And so look at all your times and your temperatures and all that good stuff and make sure you make it happen. Here's another tune for you guys. When we come back, we'll have a little more updates on this incredible meal we have tonight. Zuppa Di Pesce. Pesca.
Pesca. Pesh.
Zuppa Di Pesce. So Iron Man Mo wants to know, did you add the love yet? She's wondering.
If by love you mean Pinot Grigio, then absolutely I did.
She said earlier that that's exactly what she meant by Pinot Grigio. That is the love that she was talking about.
I'm a Pinot Grigio girl tonight and forever.
I'm a Pinot girl.
We
Keynote girl.
That's right. I like it. Boom. Mike Conway, you're up, bro. You're getting paid tonight. We're paying you in Zuppa Di Pesce.
Come with me.
Come with me. And you can see. In a world of pure Zuppa Di Pesce. Oh, Mike. Dude, that looks and smells. What's up, Sherry? Good to see you.
Sherry in the his house.
Right, Sherry in the house. Man, that looks fake. Can you do that again? Can you get down, get down? Down, down, down. Look at that. Oh, look at the steam. Nice. You guys smell that?
Smell-o-vision.
If you guys haven't, okay, so if you're on an iPhone or if you're on a Google Play Market, you can update the Facebook application and you can get the smell plugin, which is really cool. What it's going to do, it's going to analyze and it's going to mimic the specific smells that we smell here and it's going to give it to you over Wi-Fi. How fantastic is that?
It's true. We've developed this technology over many years.
We did. That is very true. Guys, if you are looking for the Sherry that we've been talking about, Sherry is sharing. Share there bear. She is right there. The lovely Share Bear, Sherry Harmon Callahan, joined us on Wednesday for such a cool interview. And we had such a good time, and it was fantastic. Sherry, thank you so much for joining us Wednesday night. It was great. And I think the great Jespy, are you adding some seafood right now? Is that what's going on?
No, because I don't know if that's the next step
or not. It's the next step. Oh, yeah. She already did it.
I'm gonna do it then.
Yeah, were you not? Yeah. Now remember, she said the muscles don't take very long, so she staggered it appropriately. If you were watching the video and paying attention,
I was absolutely watching, and at the same time, I was also paying attention. So I definitely 100% know that I am good to go.
All right,
I'm
sweet.
I'm gonna do that because I know what I'm doing because I was paying attention.
All right, let's add some seafood. We're going to follow Jess B into the kitchen here. The great, our maniac man, Mike Conway, making it happen. Our cameraman of the evening. Oh, man, looking good. Bringing it down. Adding in. Oh, is that the cod? Ooh, adding in that delicious cod. And the cool thing about this is once everything is ready to rock and roll, the pasta is not going to take very long to cook. The seafood isn't going to take very long to cook at all. Where's your microphone? Where's your microphone? We can't hear you. Oh, yeah, you got three hands. You need three hands.
Said I do already have the water going for the pasta because, as I mentioned before, I'm definitely paying attention. I absolutely know what I'm doing. I didn't space out at all. I'm prepared.
We're all prepared. Boom. Are those the scallops right there that you're getting ready to add in?
Yes.
Boom. There we go, Tally. That's what I'm talking about.
It's so important to have help.
It is. That's Tally Lockhart. We said you need three hands, and boom, Tally was ready to rock and roll. Look at those nails. Did you guys both get your nails done today? They look fantastic.
Perfect microphone height. Yeah. And yes, I said microphone, not microphone, because Pinot Grigio. Hey, here we are.
Uh-oh, here we go. Nice, man. So we're adding that seafood in.
I should probably add the shrimp, though, if I was the person who knew what I was doing.
I would definitely add those shrimp. Again, and the seafood's not going to take very long. There's a lot of water in that seafood, so the seafood is going to cook really quickly. Shrimp are going to cook really quickly, especially once you get that base. You get that salsa up to the right temperature. Once you get that seafood in there, it's going to cook pretty quick. So we are nearing the end of this. Stephanie's been working really hard in the background. All the previous recordings that you guys are seeing are from Mineral Bluff just a couple weeks ago. Jess B is here trying to mimic the mimic of the mimic as she makes her own Zuppa Di Pesce for these incredible people here to be able to enjoy. How's it going over there, Jess? How you feeling?
I feel fantastic. I also feel that I'm a little anxious about whether all the muscles are going to fit in here, but you know what? I'm calm, cool, collected, and I think it's going to be a good time.
Oh, yeah, they're definitely going to fit. They're definitely going to fit.
I'll try it.
If it fits, it ships. That's it, kids. So I'm going to play a jam for you guys. Then we're going to come back and we're going to chat and see what else is going on in the kitchen tonight because we are nearing the end of this glorious show. And that Zuppa Di Pesce is smelling absolutely amazing. So we appreciate you guys spending some time with us. Thank you guys so much for hanging out. Let me unmute that bad boy. That bad boy right there. Give a little effects right here. Yeah. There it is. All right, kids. So this is a song by New Order. And I hope you guys like it, man. This is called Bizarre Love Triangle. So if you guys like this, I most certainly hope you check out some more shows, invite us to your kitchen, and let us know if there's a song that you would like to hear us play, and we will happily, we will happily learn how to play it for you. So I hope you guys are digging it and having a good night. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Time I think of you, I feel a shot right through with a bolt of blue. It's no problem of mine, but it's a problem I find, living a life that I can't leave behind.
no sense in telling me the wisdom of a fool won't set you free. That's the way that it goes, and it's when nobody knows. Every day my confusion grows. Every time I see you falling, I get down on my knees and pray. I'm waiting for that final moment. You say the words that I can't say. I feel fine and I feel good. I'm feeling like I never should. Whenever I get this way, I just don't know what to say. Why can't we be ourselves like we were yesterday? I'm not sure what this can mean. I don't think you're what you seem. I admit to myself that if I hurt someone else, then I'll never see just what we're. Just what we're meant to be. Every time I see you falling, I get down on my knees and pray. I'm waiting for that final moment. You say the words that I can. Every time I see you falling, I get down on my knees and pray. I'm waiting for that final moment. You say the words that I can't say. I can't say. I can't say. I can't say. I can't say to you. I can't say. I can't say. I can't say. Every time I see you falling, I get down on my knees and pray. I'm waiting for those final moments. You say the words that I can't. Every time I see you falling, I get down on my knees and pray. I'm waiting for that final moment. You say the words that I can't say. I can't. Say, I can't say, I can't say, I can't say to you, I can't say, I can't say, I can't say, I can't say to you.
Thanks, guys. All right. What's up, everybody? Good to see you guys tonight. Thank you so much for spending some time with me. Yeah. Well, I will say this. The cool counter cam that we have has almost no ingredients left, which means pretty much all of them, I think, are rocking like Doc and Baby. They are in the pot, and they are cooking up, and it is smelling absolutely incredible. So with that said, we've already got the... are we going on a trip? We're going on a trip. Let's solo lay out it. We have our cameraman, Michael Conway, making it happen. Tally Jimenez, Tally Lockhart, jumping up with that... Oh, my goodness gracious. I just want to build a little tiny house on the top of one of those muscles and live there forever and ever. Amen. Look how gorgeous that looks.
In this pot.
It's a muscle house.
I was catastrophizing.
You were.
As per usual.
That's okay. But we're here. You have Tally, you have Mike, and you have myself all getting your back.
It's so important to have staff.
Iron Man Mo says, benvenuto, benvenuto.
Do you guys want to come with me when I dump this pasta?
Yeah, you do.
All right, come on, let's go.
Listen, if you want Jess B to dump your pasta, she will. You can go to jessbdumpsmypasta.com/kitchenkillaz and get 10% off her dumping your pasta.
It'll cost you.
It'll cost you to get your pasta dumped. OnlyFans.com/dumpmypasta. She's a pasta princess. Making it happen. There we go. Boop. making
that
it
was a
happen.
Sexy toss.
Yeah. Into the colander, and she's gonna get all that excess water. Now, sometimes you want a little bit of that pasta, that pasta water, but the good thing is we're mixing it into the Zuppa Di Pesce. We're adding all
those. Do you
really
think I didn't reserve any pasta water?
What is that?
Excuse me, what?
Okay, so tell us why. Why is it good to reserve some of that pasta water, Jess B?
Ordinarily, when you're making pasta, you want to reserve a little pasta water because it has all of the like starch, so it's going to thicken a sauce. I don't know if we want to thicken this sauce, but I know I'd rather have it and not need it than need it and not have it.
Amen. I hear that 100%.
As per usual.
Man, looking fantastic.
I'm just going to put this.
So the Zuppa's almost ready to rock and roll. The seafood's almost ready to rock and roll. The pasta is ready to go. We've got a couple more videos with Stephanie, and she is about to wrap this delicious dish up. Then we're going to wrap our dish up, and we're going to eat it.
That sounds delightful.
I'm fantastic. Here's another video for you guys. I hope you like it. If you don't, it's Chris Chapman's fault.
Welcome back, everybody, and welcome to Friday Night. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is...
Stephanie Sutton.
Yeah, it is. What's up? Tonight, we are your Kitchen Killaz. We're here in a beautiful, beautiful cabin here in Georgia. We hope you guys are having a good Friday night. And let's touch base with Stephanie and see what's going on, because the water is ready to rock and roll. We're going to add that pasta. She's got some mussels that she's going to add, and she's going to walk you through why it's good to add a little pinch of salt to your water before you add your pasta. Let's check it out.
We have our chosen sea salt here. So we're going to add a little, just a little sprinkle of salt to our boiling pasta water there. What this does is it helps keep the pasta from sticking together. Just real little tip, nice and easy. Got our nice kind of fresh pasta here. This is a really good, you can get this in the like where the cheeses are and things like that, these butoni pasta. I like to use this. It just has a little nicer flavor than the dry pasta, and it takes way less time to cook, like 2 minutes. So we've got our nice hot water there. I'm gonna go ahead and throw this bad boy into the pool. Ooh, watch it expand. So nice and bubbly. Get that going, and I'm gonna stir it a little bit too, because we need to stir it, break it up. Get that going. And while that kind of bubbles away with the pasta dish, we're gonna go ahead and add our mussels in their garlic butter sauce, so we're getting more flavor. Get them bad boys in. We don't need that shell. He can hang out. And then we'll stir them around. Oh yeah. Get it going. So that pasta is probably about a minute and a half left, and then we'll be ready to plate.
Guys, we are closing in to this dish. It is smelling incredible. Zuppa Di Pesce. That's right, I got it right that time. Zuppa Di Pesce, walking through you guys all the individual ingredients that you need to make such a delicious meal like this. And I'm super excited. The kitchen smells great. The plating's going to be fantastic. And I want to thank you guys for being here tonight. We are in the middle of a little bit of an interim concept. The great Commodore has decided to step away from the Kitchen Killaz in pursuit of other ventures. We wish him the absolute best of luck. So tonight, Stephanie Sutton and I are your Kitchen Killaz. We're here at a beautiful cabin right here in Georgia. What a beautiful place. It's been such a fun weekend so far. We got a couple more days ahead of us, and tonight, a delicious, delicious dish made by Stephanie. She's made it a couple times before. I have never actually seen it made in real time, but that's what's happening now. We are only a couple of steps away from plating it and enjoying this delicious meal. So with that said, I hope you guys enjoy this next song as well. Thanks for hanging out with us tonight. This is previously recorded, but we are in the chat, so go ahead and say something to us in the chat. Pop up, we'll talk back, we'll sell some websites, all that good stuff. We're having a really good night, and thank you so much for spending some time with us. And again, enjoy your Friday night, and enjoy this next song. Thanks.
What's up, everybody? Hello, hello, and it's good to see you. Mike Conway, you're up again. So we're making it, man. We are closing in. Everything is looking good. I think the next video, I think we want to see what Jess B is making over there before I show the next video, because I believe the next video is the presentation. That's what I believe. Then, oh, boom, there we go. Oh yeah, adding it in, making it happen. Look at this. The pasta is going to cook really quick. Now this pasta is soup is pretty fresh pasta, so it's not going to take the 12 to 14 minutes it would normally take for dry pasta to cook. It's just not going to take that. It did it again, Mike Conway. I don't know what's going on, man. We're just going to make it out. Boop, done. So, yeah, man. Boop, done. So, yeah, man, we are nearing it. It is smelling incredible. I'm so excited. So, we have just a couple more videos. So, I'm going to go ahead and play Stephanie. Oh, wait. Nope, we're back. We're back.
Just kidding. Here we are.
All right. Look at this. Oh, my goodness gracious. Here we go. It's done. We're doing it. I'm going to bring this up.
So, fun fact about mussels. If the mussels don't open, you don't want to eat them.
You don't want to eat them.
Like, they wanted to live in their house, and you should let them.
Oh, my goodness gracious. You know, look at them shrimps.
I just want to make sure I get a proper representative sample.
Oh, they're looking fantastic. Of the
seafood. There we go.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Look at that. I'm going to bring up.
Hang on 1 second. Come here.
Come here. Let's bring up this other counter cam right here. Let's see what's going on. Look at this. What?
Roll that fresh parsley on top. Oh,
a little fresh parsley. Bip, bip, bip.
A little garnish.
A little garnish, making it happen.
And you know what? It's not Christmas, but we're going to make it just a little bit, just a hint.
What is that?
It's cheese.
Cheese!
Which ordinarily you wouldn't put, you know, dairy with seafood in this regard, but I think it's nice. I think it's special and fancy.
I think it looks absolutely amazing. Are you kidding me? It is definitely nice. It is definitely fancy. It smells so good.
It would be more amazing if there were calamari and if I had cooked the onions and peppers with butter and not olive oil, but here we are.
Hey, man, you added
some
butter.
She's being very hard on herself. It sounds amazing.
Yeah, she really is. It smells amazing and it looks really good and I'm excited to taste it.
I can't even smell it anymore.
Well, we're closing in. Let's play this second to last video with Stephanie Sutton, making it happen and cooking it in Mineral Bluff, making Zuppa Di Pesce for everybody. Hope you guys are digging it and having a fantastic night. Thank you guys so much for spending some time with us. And here is the next to last video. I think Stephanie Sutton's about to make it happen in the kitchen, baby. So let's watch and see how it goes. Welcome back, everybody. It's Friday night. I'm here with Stephanie Sutton in a beautiful mineral bluff.
Come on, Billy.
Zuppa Di Pesce and mineral bluff. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. We are closing in. It is time to plate, ladies and gentlemen. The moment we have all been waiting for, these beautiful colors and flavors all culminating in a dream, ladies and gentlemen, an absolute dream. Well, my girl Stephanie chops up some parsley, oregano. What was that?
It's cilantro. Parsley, Italian parsley.
It was Italian parsley. I got that one right. Ding, one for Billy. Let's check in with Stephanie because it is time to add some of this delicious pasta and top it with this Zuppa Di Pesce that we've been working so hard on. Yay. Actually, she's been working really hard on. I've just been hitting a lot of buttons. Let's talk with Steph.
Yay. All right, so first we're gonna grab our delicious pasta. Look how yummy that looks. You know, to taste, whatever, however much your heart desires. We'll give it a little twist in there. I like to add the pasta and the sauce separately rather than just throwing the sauce in there. I'm gonna use this bad boy because it's gonna help us get those nice chunks of fish. Look at those mussels. Oh my gosh, the scallops, the shrimp, the mahi. Oh my gosh, the chunky tomatoes. Look at that, the capers, you can just really see that there. So we'll get our nice stuff in there and then the sauce spoon, just to add a little bit, however much your heart desires. I'm gonna do a little bit of light sauce there because I like to still taste the pasta. Let's not drown it out. And then of course, cleaning as we go, keeping our plates nice and nice when we're serving others. At least I like to, you don't have to do this. You can eat it however you want. And then we're gonna throw some delicious Italian parsley on top. Little sprinkle, there it goes.
Wow. Holy Tedesco. That looks in freaking incredible. Look at that. Look at these delicious ingredients real quick. Here, let me be your Van Wyde.
Yeah,
hold
please.
This nice hot bowl.
Please.
So walk us through. What do we have in here real quick, Steph?
So we've got our fresh fettuccine that we boiled pretty quickly, which is great. And then we've got our garlic butter mussels. That's because all we could find at the grocery store. Some bay scallops, some shrimp, some capers, some onions, some peppers, that delicious sauce. It's ready to go. It's ready for you to take a bite, or at least watch us take a bite.
Oh yeah.
It's gonna be good stuff.
We're gonna grab some forks. You guys enjoy this next song, man. We're gonna jump on this one. It's gonna be fantastic. I'm really looking forward to it. Smells incredible. Zuppa Di Pesce over the fettuccine. So good. You can see that steam. You guys can even smell it if you have the new update for the Facebook application. You can even smell it.
Well, Billy's throwing parsley on the floor.
I'm just throwing parsley on the floor.
It's
listen,
crazy.
It's a celebration.
Wild.
We'll be right back, guys. We're going to do a taste of this. We're going to say goodbye, and thank you so much for hanging out with us tonight. My name is Billy Floyd, and that is...
Stephanie Sutton.
That's right, baby doll. This is Zuppa Di Pesce for your mouth, and we'll talk to you guys soon. This looks so good. Zuppa Di Pesce for your mouth. Fantastic. Well, I got one more song to play for you guys, and then we are going to dive face first into this incredible Zuppa Di Pesce that has been made. It smells incredible, and it's so awesome. I was really excited to work with Stephanie. Her and I have very competitive spirits. We have a very, very similar energy, and I know that Stephanie and I hanging out with each other was so much fun. Stephanie, I hope you had as much fun as I did. I love the cabin. Sherry, thank you so much for allowing us to be there. It was such an amazing experience, and we're trying to talk all of our friends into joining us in this incredible cabin as well. So we're probably going to be in touch soon. But with that said, I got a jam I'm going to play for you guys. I hope you guys are digging it and having a really good night. Thank you so much for spending some time with me. My name is Billy Floyd. I'm a kitchen killer from Orlando, Florida. I'm classified as a touring acoustic solo, crashing kitchens around the country. I do it every Friday and do it
for free.
Now that was awesome. That was fantastic. So this is called Run With Me. I hope you guys dig it, man. And if you don't, it's Mike Conway's fault. Sorry. It's not Chris Chapman's fault anymore. I think I hurt his feelings. It's not Chris Chapman's fault. That's my boy. So here we go.
Just when you need me to, yeah. Shallow words bid fortune away from my tongue. One truth be told, I love you till my dying day comes, and I'll ask you, what shall be my life when the shadow my shame, away my shame. Scarlet hair bids fortune to draw me in. One truth be told, I'm hypnotized and mesmerized, my friend. And I'll ask you, would you run with me, escape the chaos, and rock with me tonight? And so I'll tell you, my love, won't you run escape the chaos and rock with me tonight. And rock with me tonight. And so I'll ask you, and so I'll ask you, would you run with me, escape the chaos, and rock with me tonight? And so I'll tell you, my love, won't you run with me, escape the chaos, and rock with me. Escape the chaos, rock with me. Escape the chaos and rock with me tonight.
Tonight, thank you so much for spending some time with me. My name is Billy Floyd. Back there, the great and illustrious Jess B.
Oh,
making it happen. We also have a great Kitchen Killaz crew this evening. Michelle Hess in the house taking some photos. She is posting up all the songs, everything that you guys see here. She's taking care of. We have Johnny, her right-hand man, making it happen. We have Chris Chapman, Tally Lockhart, our wonderful microphone holder. And we have our engineer this evening, our additional cameraman, Mike Conway, the cameraman himself, making it happen. Boom, there he is, trimmed, fit, single, and ready to mingle, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, yeah, baby. So let's see what we got going on in here, because I already see some fantastic food flying around, and we're making it happen. And here is, I see Mike already digging in. I love it, man. I love it.
Dinner has been dished up.
Dinner has been dished up,
he's
baby.
Everyone's working hard, so.
I see the wine. I see the food. I see it's ready to rock and roll. It's ready to plate. It's ready to eat. So we have one more video of Stephanie and I sitting down and actually having a bite of this delicious meal.
It's my favorite video so far. So picturesque.
It is very picturesque. At the cabin in Mineral Bluff in Blue Ridge, Georgia. Absolutely beautiful location. You can go to lovemycabin.com. A huge shout out to Sherry, to Iron Man Mo, to Stephanie. Thank you guys so much for not only being a part of the show tonight. We really, really appreciate it. All the recordings that you are seeing are of myself and the great Stephanie Sutton. You can actually hear Jess's cute little laugh in the background a couple times. So this last video is the culmination of absolute amazing creativity. The great Stephanie Sutton and I sitting down and enjoying a bite of this delicious Zuppa Di Pesce paired with a wonderful white wine.
Welcome back, everybody. It is Friday day, evening-ish. And we are here in Wellborn, North Georgia. Myrtle Beach, Georgia. No, Welling Wish, Georgia. No, that's not right either.
Come on,
Marvel
Billy.
Blush. Martian Blessing.
That's it.
Martian Blessing.
Martian Blessing.
Welcome to Martian Blessing, Georgia. We are here in beautiful, in this beautiful cabin. So gorgeous.
Yes, my mountain
the food
dream.
Looks great. My mountain dream.
Shout out to Share Bear.
Yeah, what's up, Share Bear? If you have a mountain dream, you can always reach out to them. Find them all over Instagram. And I imagine, do they have TikTok? Do they have Facebook? Where is the
Facebook,
best place to go?
Facebook, and then they have a website, lovemycabin.com.
I love it. Sherry and Steven.
Sherry and Steven.
I got it right. Sherry and Steven. Ladies and gentlemen, Zuppa Di Pesce. Here
Zuppa
we go.
There
all this
is.
Good stuff. We got some scallops,
delicious.
Some shrimp. You can actually eat the shell of the mussel, which is fantastic. You can eat the shell of the mussel, right?
If you'd like to break your teeth, you can.
Okay. But it
that means
so
no.
Okay. That.
Don't break your teeth. That hurts.
All
that's
right.
not
well,
fun. Nobody wants a dental
there.
Bill.
There we go. We got some of the scallops right here, some of the shrimp, this beautiful cilantro, and this fettuccine Alfredo, or this fettuccine pasta, not Alfredo.
The boy, he needs to eat. Is it good? What do you think? Should I get a bite?
Oh my god.
I'm gonna have a bite.
Oh yeah. You've gotta try this.
The chef has to eat last.
Mm.
Oh my goodness. Look at all that pasta.
Oh, the scallops and the shrimp.
Delicious.
Mmm. The sauce itself, amazing. The flavor of everything kind of comes together. The pasta's super delicate.
Mm-hmm.
Really great. Oh man, those green peppers. Those green peppers kind of set it off.
Yeah.
Oh,
just
I love
a little,
that texture.
A little pizzazz, you know?
Man, this is looking absolutely fantastic. So, you've made this many times. What do you think?
I think it's pretty darn good.
Yeah?
It's for making it at a cabin
in
Mineral Bluff, close to Blue Ridge, Georgia, with no ocean in sight.
None.
It tastes really darn good.
That's right.
So, you know, I like it. Rustic cabin, rustic Italian, we're here for it.
That is very true. Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. I really appreciate a little bit of an interim concept in the middle of the interim concept. Our guest chef of the evening, Stephanie Sutton, making it happen. Cooking some fantastic food. We had really good food last night. You cooked up those burgers. I learned a lot. I'm about to learn a little bit more, and I just learned how to make Zuppa Di Pesce. So I hope you guys did too. I hope you had a fantastic Friday night. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with us. We really appreciate it. We are going to get to this incredible meal and this incredible wine. Cheers, Stephanie Sutton. Thank you very much for everything. Really appreciate this. You guys have a good night. Salud. Stay out of trouble. And like Stephanie said, manja, manja. Make it happen, baby. We'll talk to you guys soon. Have a good one. This is so good.
Cheers,
love. Love it. Oh, fantastic.
Beautiful time.
High five. Bye, guys.
Man, that was awesome. Guys, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Most certainly appreciate it. And a huge shout out to Stephanie Sutton for cooking an absolutely gorgeous, 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 gorgeous meal. Chatting to that microphone. Let's see if you sound okay.
Gorgeous, gorgeous girl.
How's that sound? Sound okay?
Gorgeous meal.
Oh, you stop it. If you want Jess B to talk to you like that, she can. It's $9.99 a minute, $20.99 each additional minute.
Name your favorite word and I will speak it aloud for you.
Look at this. Look at this delicious. This Zuppa Di Pesce looking fantastic.
I'm beklempt.
Man, I kind of want to freeze it and I want to hang it on the wall because that just freaking looks amazing, dude. Look at that. Zuppa Di Pesce making it happen. Iron Man Mo, I hope you dig it. A huge shout out to Stephanie Sutton. Thank you so much, guys, for spending some time with us tonight. Mo, we certainly are so happy to be here playing some music for you. We got a great crowd tonight. Our cameraman, Mike Conway, let's give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, making it happen, baby.
Single ladies.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
know
yeah.
Anybody.
He's single. He's fit. He's ready to rock.
He's also a very nice person.
He's one of my favorite dudes.
And he knows how to build things.
He has an incredible moral character.
Oh, my
and
God.
And also,
he's a Virgo.
By the way, you were nominated today during our management meeting for a chili cook-off competition. It was myself and Danny Sanz's fault. You're welcome.
Look at him go.
So good. So let's dive in to this Zuppa Di Pesce right here. What do you think?
Nervous.
Before you even jump into it, what do you think?
I think it looks great, which makes me feel like it doesn't taste that good.
Oh, I bet it's going to be amazing. I've seen...
Aesthetically, it is fantastic.
Oh, goodness gracious. Look at those plump shrimp.
Okay, I'll make it happen.
Oh yeah, I'll chat a little bit while you take your bite. Oh, look at this pasta right here.
Performance anxiety.
You're right. Just go ahead and do it. Just go ahead and do it. You're good. So we have the Zuppa Di Pesce night. We have some scallops. We have some cod. We have some delicious shrimp. Absolutely fantastic. Making it happen, man. Absolutely tasty, tasty, tasty. We got some mussels in there, which are really good as well. Plus, we walked you guys through exactly how to make the base, how to make the salsa, how to make the pasta. Really, really good pasta. Again, we didn't get the dry pasta. We got the fresh pasta, and you can go to a place like Publix.
We made it by hand.
We picked it off the Absolutely. Off the pasta tree. We had a pasta tree pasta in the backyard. Tree. So how do you feel about that, Jespy? How's your flavor? How's the flavor profile and all that other good stuff? We're making it happen tonight, kids. A huge shout out again to Stephanie Sutton, to Iron Man Mo. Thank you so much to Cher Bear. Thank you for having us. To our crew here at the house tonight, Michelle and Johnny, Chris and Tally, our fantastic cameraman, Michael Conway. The illustrious and amazing Jammin' Jespy making
what
it happen.
What else do you like about me?
And we and we really appreciate you guys spending some time with us tonight. This is some Zuppa Di Pesce made. We walked you guys through all the ingredients that you can use to make it at home yourself. Very simple, very easy to make. Smells incredible, absolutely full of flavor. And I'm going to let Jespy talk while I take a bite here. Here we go.
Ordinarily, I'm pretty hard on myself when it comes to cooking because I feel like I cook for whoever I'm cooking for. If I'm cooking for myself, I'm like, I don't care what it looks like or what it tastes like. It's just I need to eat something. But I do think I did a good job. Like, I think I seasoned it. It's a little bit, it's a little salty, but I like salty, so I don't care.
Sounds good.
Tally says it's good. But Tally's also Puerto Rican, so I know she likes it salty, too.
I do like it salty. It goes through my veins.
Cook for your audience.
Oh my God, that is incredible.
I think it's good. I noticed a lot of the mussels that I purchased on sale from Publix didn't want to come out of their home. If
that, is
that
really
happens
good.
To you and you're buying mussels and cooking them and they're like, I'm not going to open up, man, don't that, force them. Man, don't force pasta. Them out of their house because they like, you won't like what they do to you if you make them come out of their house and they don't want to.
Oh, that pasta is fantastic. The base, the red sauce is absolutely just. I'm going to get some more of that red sauce because that like is that? Super, super
Here, try
tasty.
Mine. Mine has more sauce than yours.
Salsa.
I gave myself the better portion.
I gave myself that sauce. Oh yeah. Oh, this is nice and this is nice and wet and tasty.
Oh my goodness gracious. Oh, you get out of here.
What do you like about it? Different. Like I would like specifics.
Okay. So we use three different cans. We use two tomato sauce and we use a chef cut. And the chef's cut, tomatoes.
Incorrect.
No, that's what Stephanie did.
Stephanie used the chef's cut.
Okay.
At our Publix, they did not have the chef's cut. And what the chef cut is that I learned when I Googled it, when I was having a panic attack in the tomato aisle before I called Stephanie, is that the chef's cut are plum tomatoes that they have the top and the bottom cut off. And I said, oh, so I should get peeled tomatoes? And she goes, absolutely not. She said, get diced tomatoes. And that's what I did. And I'm glad I called her in my moment of panic. Because apparently it's great.
I like the diced tomatoes. They add the texture to it, that soft texture to it, where it's not you're not just dealing with tomato sauce, but you actually have the taste and the flavor and the texture of that tomato itself that's still in there and goes perfectly paired with the seafood.
Yeah, and realistically, I did start cooking down the peppers and the onions at like honestly 8:30, so it has been about like 3 hours plus of like just building
2.5
building flavor.
2 hours 17 minutes.
First of all, the math ain't mathin'.
We don't math on Fridays. Zuppa Di Pesce paired with a delicious
Pinot Grigio.
There we go. Paired with a delicious Pinot Grigio. So we walked you guys through making some great Zuppa Di Pesce. A huge shout out to again Stephanie Sutton for cooking this in Mineral Bluff Blush Vicious Mineral Pesque. Yeah, Mineral Bluff. That's right, baby. So Mineral Bluff, Georgia, we were so happy to be there. It was a beautiful cabin. A huge shout out to Cher Bear and Steven for allowing us to crash such a gorgeous place. If you guys are looking for a place like that to go, which you are, go to lovemycabin.com and you can find it. You can rent it. You can go there. You can experience what we experienced it. And you can cook some incredible food in this fully functional, ready to rock and roll kitchen. Sherry has made it so when you walk in the door, you are home sweet home, ready to relax immediately. And if you like s'mores, once you walk in the door, there's all the ingredients you need to make your own s'more. She hooks it up, man. They go into every room. It is well taken care of. I've stayed in a lot of Airbnbs. I would say by far best Airbnb I've ever stayed in. So a huge shout out to Sherry for having us there. To Stephanie, thank you so much for cooking and recording that with me. It was a lot of fun. To Jess B for crushing it in the kitchen tonight. My man Michael Conway on the camera this evening. And my name is Billy Floyd. I'm a kitchen killer from Orlando, Florida. Classified as a touring acoustic solo, crashing kitchens around the country. I do it every Friday and I do it.
For free.
That's right, baby. We'll talk to you guys soon. We're going to get into this Zuppa Di Pesce. We'll see you Monday at 7:05. You guys have a fantastic weekend. My name is Billy Floyd. That is...
Jess B.
Oh, so cute.
I know.
We'll talk to you guys soon. You guys stay out of trouble and enjoy your weekend. Be safe, guys, and we'll talk to you when we talk to you.